Opponency, Unit 6, Retirement and Death of Partner. Adjustment for current year's profit or loss up to date of retirement. When a partner is going to be retired from the partnership firm, we have to settle the retiring partner. Here we refers the continuing partners have to settle the retiring partners. When a partner is going to retire, his goodwill amount should be settled and the contribution amount and his capital account should be closed. The amount which is recorded in the capital account, that amount entirely should be handed over to retiring partners. Okay, so goodwill and then capital account amount is going to be settled. Then apart from that, suppose the partner is going to retire and the academic year end means no problem, profit and loss account will be transferred automatically. The profit of the year also distributed to the retiring partners automatically. Suppose the partner is irrespectively, meanwhile, in between the academic year, he is going to retire from the partnership firm. In as per our own wish, we can't prepare the profit and loss account during the middle time of the academic year. In that time, what they are saying, mean if a partner is going to be retired from the partnership firm and we have a preparing the profit and loss account, we can prepare the profit and loss suspense account. Profit and loss suspense account. With the help of profit and loss suspense account, we can settle the retiring partner's capital account. So, if you are going to settle the profit earned, profit amount, profit or loss which is earned during the academic year up to the date of retirement, from the academic year, the partner, the particular date when he is going to retire, up to the date, what are the transactions made, the profit or loss, it will be calculated, the amount will be distributed to the retiring partners, his share amount alone, not for the continuing partners, only retiring partners amount alone will be given. So it will be recorded in the profit and loss suspense account, not profit and loss account. So now you see here, the journal is given when you are going to calculate the profit or loss up to date of retirement, profit and loss suspense account debit to retiring partners capital account, retiring partners capital account. Now you see here, illustration number 14, Justina, Navi, Ritika are partners, three partners sharing profit and losses equally. So 1:1 is the sharing proportion. On 31st March 2019, Ritika retired from the partnership firm. Here the retirement date is given, but the academic year period is not mentioned. So now we see here, we can continue read the sum and then we can give the conclusion. Ritika retired from the partnership firm on 31st March. Profits of the year, profits of the preceding years as follows. Previous years profits are given here. 2016 5000, 2017 10000, 2018 30000. Now you see here, they specified the word preceding years profit. 2016 only they have given. They didn't mention 1st April 2015 to 31st March 2016. They didn't mention like that academic year. They have given just 2016, just 2017 and 2018. It means that 1st January to 31st December. So that's what they have given here, 2016. So the academic year is January to 31st December. So the same way, January to December. In that case, on 31st March 2019, he retired. So 2018 31st December is gets over, then 1st January 2019 academic year begins, January, February, March. So third month end Ritika is going to be retired. So from January to March 31st, Ritika worked in the partnership firm. For that, she is asking that when she is going to retire from the partnership firm, give my share of profit during the academic year for 3 months. So she is asking her share of profit for the 3 months alone. Find out the share of profit of Ritika for the year 2019. So 2019 is not yet completed. She retired on 31st March 2019. Meanwhile, middle of the period she retired. So she is asking the profit amount for 3 months alone. In that time, they have given two situations how to settle the amount for her. Profit is to be distributed on the basis of previous year profit. On behalf of Ritika, we can't prepare the profit and loss account. the entire account is not completed. So they are not ready to prepare the profit and loss account from January to 31st March 2019. What are transactions occurred? They are not ready to record it. So now they are saying that first way, you can take the previous year profit as your norms. Previous year's profit based. Last year what they have earned. Based on that you can distribute the current year profit to Ritika. So now you see here, current year is 2019. Previous year is 2018. So in 2018 what is the profit amount? 30,000. This 30,000, in this 30,000 you are going to distribute for Ritika for 3 months share. From 2018, the base of 2018 profit rupees 30,000. From this amount, Ritika's share of profit for 3 months is going to be distributed. Now you see here, the 30,000 amount for all the partners. So first we have to calculate it for Ritika's share of profit. Justina, Navina, Ritika. Third one is Ritika. So what is the share? 1:1:1. So 1/3. So 1/3, 1/3 is 3, 10/3 is 30. So 10,000. This 10,000 is the Ritika's share of profit amount for 1 year. For the entire academic year 2018. Now Ritika is relieved from the partnership firm on 31st March. So only 3 months he worked. So the 30,000 for the entire year, in that case, what is the amount for 3 months alone? 3 by 12. So 1/3 is 3, 4/3 are 12, 1/4 is 4, 25 fours are 100. So we got the value 2500. So this is the profit amount for Ritika. We have to settle for 3 months on 2019. For that we have to post the journal entry. What is the journal entry they have given? Profit and loss suspense account debit to whose returning partner? Ritika. So profit and loss suspense account debit to Ritika's capital account 2500. So now we can post the journal entry for option A. Profit and loss suspense account debit to Ritika's capital account 2500. Is recorded. Then second one, sorry.